Namaste viewers, welcome to Jnana Degula channel. Today we will go through the story of Devi BrahmaCharini, one of the incarnations, one of the manifestations of Ma Durga, the embodiment of Shakti, the embodiment of feminine aspect of the Shakti. during this Navaratri period, throughout India, Ma Shakti is worshipped in the form of different goddesses, Brahmacharini, Mahishasura Mardini, Parvati, Shailaputri, and many names, you know. Today, as a part of this Dasara, as a part of this Navaratri, we'll go through the story of Brahmacharini. And take the blessings of Brahmacharini. Please listen to the story. It's a short story. Like, share and then comment on the story. You may please put your comments in the comment box. For the benefit of the readers, you know, we have put this story in the description box also. Now, the story goes like this. Long, long time ago. Actually, these are all histories, you know. Histories being told in a very, so that it will be catchy to the listeners. Not of these things are added to these stories. Now, coming back to the story, long, long time ago, there was a very beautiful girl, daughter of the mighty Himalayas, you know, Himalaya, it was ruled by Himavanta, daughter of Himavanta. She was a very beautiful girl by name Parvati. Himalayas were the mountains, you know, he was the king of these mountains. Parvati was not an ordinary girl. She was considered as the rebirth of Sati. Sati, she had immolated herself in her previous birth in one of the occasions, in one of the celebrations by Daksha, his father, when he did a Daksha Yagna. There she immolated because she was not properly treated by his parent, his father. So this time, she is married as, taken birth as Parvati. So she was determined to marry Lord Shiva, the great God whom she loved deeply and then who had so much of attachment to him. So this is there in the mind of Parvati. One day, as usual, Narada Muni, who would be visiting everybody, and then this Narada Muni, also a very wise sage, he visited Parvati. He was talking to her and then she expressed her desire to marry Shiva. Then Narada told her, he is a very accomplished, God. He has very great powers and all those things. If you want to marry Lord Shiva again in this life also, you will have to do a very tough penance, a tough meditation, and get his attention. It is very difficult, he said. Nevertheless, Parvati, she was full of determination. She wanted to, at any cost and at every cost, she wanted to marry. Whatever be the circumstances, she wanted to marry Lord Shiva. She would be ready to do anything to please, to get the blessings and then to marry Lord Shiva. So straight away she starts her penance. The penance was not easy for anyone, but her determination was very, very, very strong. No one had ever seen such kind of a penance. Of course, the description goes like this, you know, thousands of years she ate only fruits and flowers. She did not have any homemade food, things like that. You know. She was in the forest and then she was doing penance. Always thinking about Shiva like this. Many years, you know, she ate only vegetables. Thereafter, for almost, Devi Bhagavatana describes 3,000 years. She ate nothing. She survived by eating only leaves, dry leaves. She was so much focused on her penance that she stopped even eating this also. She gave up altogether food, water, everything, and she was just simply focused on Lord Shiva. In the process, her body was getting fragile, getting frail, but her mind was very, very, very strong. So, upon seeing this, her mother was very much worried. As usual, she also came to see her. Seeing Parvati in this condition, so thin, so fragile, her mother felt very bad. She felt very bad and cried out, "Oh Ma! Oh Ma!" So, this is why Parvati was also known as Uma. This is the name given by her mother. Then when Parvati gave up eating leaves also, she was given another name, Aparna. Aparna means leaves and things like that. Aparna, not even leaves also, like that. Meaning, one who survives, without leaves also. So much was her concentration on Shiva, so much of was her concentration on the philosophical aspect. She wanted to reach Shiva. The Lord Brahma, the God of creation, he was very much impressed. He also felt very happy and very curious that she was impressed, that he was impressed by Parvati's long and very difficult penance. So he wanted to help her. He appeared before her and said, "My dear Parvati, I am very pleased with your devotion." Even Lord Shiva too is happy with your penance. I know that he is happy with your penance. I bless both of you, Lord Shiva and you together, to come together, Shiva and Shakti, you know, come together and get married in this life. So, after Lord Brahma says, you know, Parvati is also pleased that Shiva is also happy. Shiva is now, he has been pleased by Parvati's penance. Now Parvati ends her penance, and after the blessing, she marries Lord Shiva. It was her heart's deepest wish. Now, Devi Brahmacharini, as she is called, is known for her immense sacrifice, strength and purity. Devi Brahmacharini is a part of Ma Parvati. Brahmacharini, she did the penance, leaving everything, living a life of Brahmacharini, and so the name Brahmacharini. She is known for her immense sacrifice, strength and purity. On the second day of the Navaratri, the Padya Bidige, people pray to her, people are devoted to her, and they seek her blessings for strength and focus in their actions in life, whatever actions they do, you know, they want, and they seek her blessings so that they can focus on certain actions. They also hope to follow her example of dedication and devotion to Lord Shiva, or anything, any action, any work, you know, they do. They want that kind of a focus. They seek that kind of a blessing from her so that they can focus on their own lives. Of course, to appear, you know, she holds a rosary in one hand and a water pot in the other, which symbolizes peace, wealth and happiness. Many people, you know, during this period fast during this Navaratri, and just like Parvati did her penance, they pray to Devi Brahmachari for strength and stay focused and dedicated to what they love and what they wish to do. Viewers, this ends the story of Devi Brahmacharini. I hope the story was quite interesting and then quite inspirative. With this, we will conclude this story. We once again request you to kindly like, share and then subscribe to my channel and listen to this story. Thank you for your valuable time.